Hi, my name is Professor Eitan Okun, and I'm a neuroimmunologist studying vaccines in the elderly and in brain pathologies. I have recently came across this short clip by Dr. Robert Malone, who claims that the mRNA vaccines against COVID-19 cause irreparable damage specifically in children. So let's see what Dr. Malone has to say and refer to his claims one by one.
My name is Robert Malone. I'm a physician and a scientist. But more importantly, I'm a father and a grandfather. I don't usually read from a prepared speech, but this is so important that I wanted to make sure that I got every single word and fact, scientific fact, correct. I stand by this statement with a career dedicated to vaccine research and development. I'm vaccinated for COVID, and I'm generally pro-vaccination. I've devoted my entire career to developing safe and effective ways to prevent and treat infectious diseases. After this, I'll be posting the text of this statement so that you can share it with your friends and family. Here's the thing. Before you inject your child, a decision that is irreversible, I wanted to let you know the scientific facts about this genetic vaccine, which is based on the RNA vaccine technology I created.
So let us speak about Dr. Malone's contribution to the development of mRNA vaccines. This information can be basically found easily on the web, but I've also put some links in the description below. Nevertheless, I will just quickly summarize. Dr. Robert Malone is a virologist and immunologist who studied messenger RNA technology, pharmacology, and conducted drug repurposing research. His studies on mRNA technology commenced in the 1980s when he helped discover that it was possible to transfer messenger RNA protected in a liposome, similarly to how Pfizer's and Moderna's vaccines work, into cultured cells to signal information needed for the production of protein. In the early 1990s, he collaborated with additional researchers and suggested the possibility of synthesizing messenger RNA to induce the production of a desired protein. Dr. Malone claims to be the inventor of messenger RNA vaccines, while in fact mRNA vaccines were the result of the contribution of hundreds of researchers, in addition to Dr. Malone. Later, Dr. Malone worked in several pharmaceutical companies, most of which attempted to take existing drugs and repurpose them to other pathologies, such as infections by the Zika virus and of course COVID-19. During the COVID-19 pandemic in the early 2020s, Dr. Malone was involved in attempts to repurpose existing drugs such as famotidine and the anti-malarial hydroxychloroquine as a COVID-19 drug repurposing research. All of these attempts failed due to various reasons. He later attempted to promote the self-medication with ivermectin, another drug that failed to treat COVID-19 in clinical trials. It is unknown whether these failures are the cause behind Dr. Malone's actions to spread misleading information on COVID-19 vaccines.
There are three main issues that parents need to understand before they take this irrevocable decision. The first is that a viral gene will be injected into your parent's cells. This gene forces your child's body to make toxic spike proteins.
The way Dr. Malone presents the concept of production of the spike proteins by our cells is misleading. In the case of COVID-19, the viral protein that is used to vaccinate against is called the spike protein. This protein is used by the SARS-CoV-2 virus in order to attach to cells in our body, allowing it to enter the cells. This is why we want our body to generate antibodies against the spike protein, and in this way to block its entry to the cells. Vaccinating against other viral proteins will not prevent entry of the virus to the cells. Therefore, there is little sense in describing the vaccine as inserting a toxic protein to our cells. Dr. Malone claims that the spike protein is toxic to cells in our body. So first of all, studies now show that the spike protein made by the virus itself damages our cells in ways that we were not aware of before. This is, in fact, one of the reasons that we want to vaccinate against this virus to begin with. You see, once the virus infects you, and it will eventually infect the entire population, it can potentially damage cells and lead to long-term consequences. Besides the short-term danger of acute respiratory syndrome, which is basically how the virus kills people, there are also long-term consequences known as long COVID, which appears in about 10% of those that show symptoms of COVID-19. These long-term symptoms include fatigue, respiratory difficulties, loss of the sense of smell, and others. One important thing to remember is that upon viral infection, each infected cell produces a huge number of viruses. This number is estimated between 1 billion viruses to 100 billion viruses per person. Multiply this by the number of the spike proteins expressed on each virus, and you will get the number of spike proteins that vastly overwhelms the number of spike proteins induced by the vaccine itself, as opposed to the virus. Moreover, since the mRNA in the vaccine breaks down within roughly 2 days, the number of spike proteins produced by the vaccine itself is limited both in number and time. And after several days, there is no trace of the vaccine-induced spike protein. Therefore, claiming that you should not be vaccinated because the spike protein in the vaccine will damage you, whereas infection by the virus, which produces tons of more spike proteins in comparison, simply doesn't make any sense. A list of research papers that indicate the various processes that are negatively affected by the spike protein during viral infection can be found in the description below.
These proteins often cause permanent damage in children's critical organs. These organs include their brain and nervous system, their heart and blood vessels, including blood clots, their reproductive system.
Dr. Malone actually claims that vaccinating against the spike protein of the SARS-CoV-2 virus causes damage to various organs. This is clearly false information. In fact, there is no evidence or a study that supports these claims, which completely discredits Dr. Malone's claims. It is a shame that a person that decades ago was familiar with the rigorous method of making scientific claims results to spreading these clearly unbased claims.
And most importantly, this vaccine can trigger fundamental changes to their immune system.
Well, at least Dr. Malone got this one right. Vaccination specifically activates the immune system and drives it to act in order to be better prepared for an incoming viral infection.
The most alarming point about this is that once these damages have occurred, they are irreparable. They cannot be reversed. You can't fix the lesions within their brains. You cannot repair heart tissue scarring.
This is quite dramatic, but this drama is not needed since it is based on false claims that mRNA vaccines against the spike protein cause damage to various internal organs such as the brain, the heart, etc.
You cannot repair a genetically reset immune system.
This sentence is a real puzzle for me. There is no such term as genetically reset immune system, not in the context of vaccinations anyways. So this sentence sounds frightening, as I assume was the meaning of it, but it belongs to the realms of science fiction rather than science.
And this vaccine can cause reproductive damage that could affect future generations of your family.
This is another well-known fake claim. It should be cleared that despite billions of vaccines administered worldwide to prevent COVID-19, there is no evidence of damage to fertility. In fact, exposure to the SARS-CoV-2 virus itself causes abortions. Links to relevant research can be found in the description below, and a link to a video I previously made on why vaccines against the spike protein do not cause fertility issues should appear somewhere on your screen now.
The second thing you need to know is about the fact that this novel technology has not been adequately tested. We need at least 5 years of testing and research before we can really understand the risks associated with this new technology. The harms and risk from new medicines often become revealed many years later.
Regarding the potential long-term effects of newly developed drugs, we need to say the following things. When developing drugs or vaccines aimed against a protein of our own body, typically there is a need to prove that the target of the specific treatment is only that particular protein, whether it is expressed on a tumor cell or any other cell in our body. The aim there is indeed to verify that no damage will occur to proteins that are not our target. Indeed, most drug development in the world fails at this point. In contrast, when drugs or vaccines are developed to target foreign targets, whether these are proteins in bacteria or viruses, we make use of the fact that our immune system would have recognized these proteins as foreigns to begin with and would have attacked them with all its possible tools. Our aim in developing vaccines against such pathogenic proteins is to help the body to protect itself ahead of time, since some pathogens can elicit significant damage to the infected person prior to effective activation of the immune system, as often is the case with elderly individuals or people with impaired immunity. Going back at least as far as the polio vaccine development, which was widely released to the public in the 1960s, we've never seen a vaccination with long-term side effects, meaning side effects that occur several months or years after injection. And in every vaccine available to us today, side effects, including rare but serious side effects, develop within 6 to 8 weeks of injection. COVID-19 vaccines have been studied in humans for more than 2 years now, and more than 8.5 billion vaccines have been administered worldwide. These COVID-19 vaccines have been shown to be extremely safe.
I ask you to ask yourself, as a fellow parent, if you want your child to be part of the most radical experiment in human history.
The drama intensifies here when Dr. Malone suggests that we are all part of the most radical experiment in human history. I don't remember us asking the COVID-19 pandemic to happen, but I do know, however, the numbers related to it. Despite the development and administration of vaccines against the SARS-CoV-2 virus, 5.36 million people died at the time of preparing this video as a result of this particular virus alone. It is clear that in absence of vaccines, this number would have been much, much higher.
One final point. The reason they're giving you to vaccinate your child is a lie. Your children represent no danger to their parents or grandparents. It's actually the opposite. Their immunity after getting COVID is critical to save your family, if not the world, from this disease.
This claim by Dr. Malone is totally wrong and not based on scientific evidence. Research done in the past 2 years has shown that the viral load among non-vaccinated individuals, including children, is significantly higher than in non-vaccinated people. You can find links to relevant research in the description below.
Finally, in summary, there's no benefit for your children or your family to be vaccinating your children against the small risks of the virus, given the known health risks of the vaccine that as a parent, you and your children may have to live with for the rest of your lives. The risk-benefit analysis is not even close with this vaccine for children.
Now, don't be lulled by the seemingly authoritative voice that Dr. Malone uses to bring his final blow down upon you. We know, because many studies were done on this, that 1. The virus spreads among non-vaccinated individuals, including children, and 2. Vaccines against COVID-19 do not pose harm to those that are vaccinated. Therefore, this summary by Dr. Malone is completely unbased and serves to frighten his audience.
As a parent and grandparent, my strong recommendation to you is to resist and fight to protect your children.
This call to arms could in fact turn out to be more damaging to the human population than any imagined side effects of any vaccine, as it is a call to ignore science and medical advance. I don't know what are the motives of Dr. Malone. Perhaps it is the failed clinical trials that he was involved in that caused him to become the misleading person that he seems to be now. And I don't call you to trust or believe in science, because science and the products of science are not a matter of belief. Instead, I'm asking you to count on rigorous science that has been done by thousands of scientists and physicians worldwide that shows that vaccines against COVID-19 are safe and provide protection against the virus that causes COVID-19.